I'm Cheryl Waters, and I have the great pleasure right now of being here with the Kills. Thank you so much for coming by. And welcome back.
Thanks.
Let's just start off with a couple of tracks you're playing tonight at the Crocodile, and we'd love a preview of what you got in store tonight.
Trace of it.
Kills on KEXP 90.3 91.7 FM, playing live at the Crocodile tonight. There's some wow for sure in that set. That is incredible. I have heard so often about the sexual energy in your shows, and I really feel a little uncomfortable being in here. Like, I need to go take a cold shower right now. That gives a new definition to sexual energy. People like D'Angelo taking their shirt off at concerts and flexing his pecs.
He's flexing here.
Yeah, totally. I mean, Jamie and Allison here, thank you so much for coming. But the way you lock eyes, and when you're not just staring into each other's eyes, you're giving each other furtive glances. That's incredible, that kind of energy that you have. I guess that's not a question, but I'm just totally overwhelmed by that performance. That's incredible.
Yeah, I guess that's kind of what, that's how we started off, really. Just we didn't play too good when we first started. We used to just sit opposite each other with a metronome or a drum machine in between, and we'd just stare at each other and kind of, we'd be making up words as we were singing, and we'd sort of like lip read each other, and then it became this kind of psychic thing where we'd sort of make up words and we'd sing the same thing together spontaneously. And I guess that's, I don't know, just the power of eye contact. We're psychic.
It's incredible. I have to say right now, you absolutely have to see them live. It's incredible. How did you come together? Allison, I know you're from Florida. I keep reading in articles, yeah, which is my home state. So I'm curious to know where you're from and how you connected with Jamie.
I'm from Florida. I was in another band for a long time, and I toured a lot and came to London quite often. So I met him at the end of the street where I was staying. He was staying upstairs and I was staying downstairs. And yeah, I don't know. I mean, I was really painfully shy, and I still kind of am too shy to talk about. But we just started talking about like books and art movements and music, and you know, he'd kind of DJ for me like 45 records within like less than an hour, playing half of a song, you know, and just teaching me stuff and showing me about music. And I don't know, we just became friends.
And is it true that you tried to write songs together through the mail for a while?
Yeah, we did for a long time. We were like 6 or 8 months or something. We did that for a while, and then, and it was really exciting. You know, it's really exciting to get that kind of a package in the mail, and it's really exciting to send that kind of a package, but it also takes a long time, so.
So you finally moved, pulled up roots. Is that where you are now? Are you in London?
Yeah.
That's incredible. Well, I can't help but ask, and I know that so many people tell you that you have such a bluesy sound to your music. Is that an influence for you? Are you aware of that? Is that something that you agree with?
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't translate too good on the radio, but I'm white and middle class and I'm English, and I don't kind of, I feel like a charlatan if I was to say I had the blues in me, but it's not really where I'm coming from musically. But I'm kind of, you know, not influenced by it, inspired by it. You know, I think that kind of the early blues of the 20s and 30s with like Doc Boggs and Charlie Patton and Robert Johnson is kind of, it has a similar lineage to what we're doing, in the sense that it's a triumph of ideas over ability. You know, they weren't like great players necessarily. They just had a fantastic energy and a real rhythm. But I feel like, I don't know, I have an affiliation with a lot of those kind of stripped down, basic, primitive things. Like the birth of electronic music is just as important to me as the birth of blues or something. You know?
Well, when you read articles and reviews about you, people are always trying to compare you to other people, but you completely have a unique sound, all your own. I wouldn't even want to try to compare you to someone else.
Good, don't.
Is it true, though, that you named this album No Wow, sort of with a feeling that there isn't a lot of music right now that makes you feel like wow?
No, it wasn't music at all. It was kind of just like a movement, like an art movement, you know, like a gathering of people doing all different kinds of art together, you know, music and films and writing books and just doing all these things, where in kind of in the past there seemed to be quite strong movements that were creatively a bit out of control.
Yeah, that's what we felt like that was missing, you know, that there used to be this kind of chaos and anarchy and creativity, like with the beatnik movement and the punk movement. You know, with the punk movement there's kids like making their own clothes and like doing poetry and fanzines, like kids from council estates, and it was just like an uncontrollable creativity. Whereas now I think, you know, it's a shame there's a lot, like labels have learnt to absorb that creativity of bands, and it's only channeled in sort of very restricted directions, like, you know, promo videos and poster campaigns, you know. And it's not, I feel like that's missing, that kind of chaos and and anarchy of like, where's it going to go next? You know, what's that band going to do next? You know, it's not just restricted to the stage or to a CD. You know, it's like, I'd like to see that again.
I'm going to take a wild guess and say that you two write together. And I've compared to the last album, this one feels very dark and moody. And I don't know if you perceive it as well. Is what kind of a state of mind were you in? Did you write this in over a short period of time or in an intense situation?
It in about 3.5 weeks. So, I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's dark and moody, but it's more kind of, we wrote in 3.5 weeks. You know, we never stopped working.
I mean, sort of lyrically, that's what we'd collected from in our journals over the last year of touring our first record. You know, we were terrible at writing songs on the road, just felt really uninspired to do that. But what we did feel inspired to do was take thousands of photographs and, like, do lots of artwork and write tons and tons of journals. And so a lot of the themes were taken from that. But I think it's interesting that it always, like, I've heard this so much, that it's, the themes are dark and moody. But I think it's weird that happens in music, you know, that's what those themes get labelled as. But in cinema and literature, they're sort of celebrated in the mainstream. It's almost expected of film to have those themes in it, you know, almost the extent where a film will bomb if it doesn't have, like, sex and violence in it. But in music, people are kind of confused and they think it's cult and underground and it's going to rape their children or something.
Where's the ooh, baby, I love you. You talk about art. I love the artwork on the album. Are either of you involved in making that?
Yeah, we did it all. We always do our artwork. It's important. It takes longer than writing the music.
It's great. Great. The new CD is incredible in its entirety, the artwork, the music. It's called No Wow. This is The Kills. Love a couple other songs if you're up for it.
We'll just add another guitar.
And I notice you're a diminutive drummer over there on the counter.
Drum machine is the most important member of the band. You good?
Yeah. If I'm so evil, why are you satisfied? If I'm so evil, why are you satisfied? Dream about your ghost, you're breathing down my neck. Idiot style in the shower, flicking your ashes down the drain. You were telling me how this ain't no rodeo town. Thank you.
Kills on KEXP 90.3 and 91.7. The CD called No Wow, playing tonight at the Crocodile. I highly recommend the show. I just feel like I got a workout watching you. It's a real pleasure to watch.